Currently heading back to Safety Harbor Art and Music Center. If you watched my last video, I was over there and I learned that the owners, Kira, Linda, and Todd, they actually have a restaurant, and if you eat at the restaurant, the proceeds go to the art center. So I was gonna go there tonight for dinner, and then I realized they close at 2 p.m. So I stopped and got Chick-fil-A on the way. And something about sitting in parking lots alone eating fast food makes my life just feel really depressing, but this is where we're at. So yeah, I'm gonna head back over to the Safety Harbor Art and Music Center because they have an open mic night every Wednesday, so really excited for that. Just arrived. It's kind of funny because I don't remember being on this street before. There's like these beige buildings. And it's the complete opposite.
I dreamed of being sweet 16 and magic 21, but now I'm 29. Seeing 30 come just to see how fast my youthful days had fleed.
And I'm thinking about the old Berlin train station and the train coming down the track. Thank you.
It's me, Your Honor. Why can't you reach a verdict? Well, I bought liquor from this guy, and if I find him guilty, he'll cut me off. The judge looks at her and he says, "Lady, you go back in there and you deliberate, or you'll be spending a long time here in the jail." And so they go back and they come back and they find him guilty, and he pays a $500 fine. I get a great little story. I find a new place to buy liquor after dark. Boom.
Thought I must have been out of my mind, but damn, he looked good to me last night.
Girls pass by waving cigarette smoke through the air, and I wonder which Earth Day these people celebrate in their Nike shoes. The Earth Day stuck in that paper cup lying neglected on the cement? All of the corporations are here for exploitation. PepsiCo stands and commercial radio stations, vendors selling foam cups and plastic wrappers to help build up ashes for the landfills. Some children show more interest in trading printouts of video game passwords than in dancing or reading about local ecology, while activists hand out paper flyers whose messages ask us to save the people and the trees.
Their hound sounds resound. The beagles are here, so cover your ears. They are canine harpies lulling you, drawing you from your home. Careful, you. Their howls subside. They can attack with slobbery tongues faster than a boyfriend's excuse. They will smother you with love until you can't breathe, leaving you to wonder where the howling went. The beagles have moved into the neighborhood, and one pig.
You cared for the fallen one by one with depth. A study never taught the doctors of the book, and now I don't believe you have surrendered. So I will visit a shipwreck in strange waters and cast it back to christening and maiden, and you will never pass away. As if you never lived.
Initially, I wrote poetry. Then one day in Lower Manhattan, in the original Sam Weiser occult bookshop, while I was sinking into the gnarled, stuffed sofa flanked by Gurdjieff and Crowley canticles, I began to write a novel which drove me to escape to the bench on the periphery of the Washington Square Park playground. Though I never finished that first attempt at fiction, I did visit Charles Olson in Gloucester, Massachusetts. Today, during summers, I'm content to visit the bench on the Bolinas Beach in California, where the long Pacific waves roll into the lagoon. Here in Florida, it's the bench on top of the Safety Harbor shell mound between the quiet Bayside Park and a most whimsical, poet-friendly art center.
I love to drown in my adversity. It lets me flourish in perversity, gives me reason to decide and let go of my better side. When I pine a lot, I think I'm calling the shots. The other side always seems greener, but there's no one to hear you, just faces with a cost.
Mothers can be a contradiction, though. Like my ma, she bakes me bread, but she won't give me dough. Now I'm almost done with my message of love to mothers everywhere, over there, below and above. Just remember to think about your mother's love and clout. Cause as my mother always says, I brought you into this world, I can take you out.
An effervescent elephant with eyes and great big trunk once whispered to the tiny ear, the ear of one inferior, that by next June you'll die. Oh yeah, because the tiger would roam. The little one said, oh my goodness, I must stay at home. And every time I hear a growl, I'll know the tiger's on a prowl.
Radiant sitting with your friends, drinking in life's reckless freedom. Studies and relationships are our only responsibilities, and they fill our world. We see nothing beyond this point. Neither can we imagine anything more important than how others see us. We adorn ourselves with confidence to cloak our insecurities. We work at fitting in. People want to be around us because we reflect them. Our manicured hands lift our mugs, and we swig the falseness of invincibility.
This evening, I've walked past a lot of political lawn signs in the River Bend neighborhood of Tampa, and I've just figured out those signs are good for shading the tender young greens coming up in my neighbor's garden. So whenever the 2020 election is over and you're done with your signs and you don't know any beekeepers who need them to insulate their hives, you mind if I take them?
I don't want my poetry heard by a bunch of gentle folk sipping lattes and making trite conversation in the coffee house du jour. I have no gracious theories about the why and the wherefore, or the beauty of butterflies and roses. I really don't give a damn. My poetry is a sideshow, the freak carnival of words that just might excite, agitate, ignite, spark your imagination, and provoke thought. And if you want a taste of this great big freak show, come on over to my kitchen of words and I'll serve it right up for you, along with a slice of after-dinner hard reality for your just dessert. So chew on that, you gentlefolk.
Many years ago, while living on the Monterey Peninsula, I directed a play at the Naval Postgraduate School. One of the actors was a lieutenant commander who was shot down in North Vietnam. He was just 30 years old. He was held captive for 2 years. There were bracelets engraved with the name of the prisoner of war. I still have one. I wore it in honor of this man. When he was released, he commented, "Continue to seek out the truth and keep the spirit of unity, which makes the country great, moving and growing."
We were at the Safety Harbor Library. I was facilitating a writer's group. And here's this man who just walks in and he has a book of poetry with him. And some people, sometimes you've probably had this happen, when you hear them read something, you think, who are you? And that's how I felt about him. I thought we had somebody, you know, doing a candid camera thing. But anyway, Roger shared this with me and it really moved me. Fairhaven Street. The coral encrusted wharf rests at the end of Union Street, where the Portuguese fishing boats nuzzle the fractured pilings like playful sea pups in the morning sun. The Chinese cook behind the coffee stained counter of the clabbered diner flips another flapjack with practiced hand and thinks of his only daughter laughing and eagerly dressing for her wedding in the distant village where he too was once a child. That was Rogers.